Follow the traces. Explore roots deep. Learn from the past. Futures to reap. Stay tuned for Qingqiao Safety. Detective. Chapter 2. Trapped, debt-ridden, and abused, a harrowing experience in the payment room. Zhang Wan's good luck did not last when she entered the casino again. The bigger the bet, the more she lost. Soon, not only did she lose the money she had won, but she also lost 10,000 yuan, and even owed the casino 100,000 yuan. Huang Yi in another casino also lost hundreds of thousands, and Lao Chen lost everything. Logically speaking, now all the money was gone, they should stop gambling. However, gamblers' psychology is that when they win, they want more; when they lose, they want to win their money back. Therefore, instead of stopping gambling, the three of them continued to advance chips from the casino, and placed high hopes on each bet, anxiously hoping a chance to turn the table. But their initial good luck never appeared again. In the next few days, each of them lost hundreds of thousands. Since then, casino employees start to tail them and follow them everywhere they go like shadows, whether they went back to the hotel, went shopping, or wandered in the casino. Then they were asked to return the money immediately, but they did not take any money here, now they are penniless. Unexpectedly, when the casino issued an ultimatum, it also listed all the family information of the three of them, requiring them to notify their families to transfer money immediately, otherwise it would make it difficult for them and their families. This scared the three of them out of their wits. It was only then that Zhang Wan, who had more social experience, realized something was wrong. Recalling all the experiences they have had since they embarked on the journey, from smuggling across the border to free food and accommodation, from giving chips to restricting money withdrawals, to big losses after big wins. The piles and pieces all became increasingly obvious indications that this is likely a fraud. When Zhang Wan told the other two about this, the three of them discussed that they must not listen to the casino to contact their families. Unexpectedly, when the casino found out that they were disobedient, they were immediately moved into payment rooms. And this is where the nightmare begins. The three of them were sent to different urge payment rooms. As the name suggests, this is a room where the casino urged these gamblers to pay back their money. These rooms are relatively clean and tidy, with food and beverage provided. But every day, the casino people will intimidate them with words, urging them to ask families for money. At the beginning, they could still brace themselves and bear the pressure. But within 2 days, the urging person came with a stick and, if they didn't comply, they would start beating. Huang Yi was beaten with a three-edged wooden stick. His chest and back were covered with bruises, the pain was as if it were burning. Zhang Wan, who originally had a flamboyant personality, was too nervous to say a word. The intermittent screams from the payment room next door made her spend every moment in fear. A few days later, all three of them were transferred to the forced payment room. If the urge payment room is more of mental intimidation, the forced payment room is more of ruthless physical torture. The room conditions are quite harsh. More than a dozen person were held together in a room less than 8 square meters. Three meals are not guaranteed. Punches and kicks became everyday life. Terrifying atmosphere permeated the surroundings. Huang Yi has been knocked unconscious, and the intense pain is almost unbearable. He even began to doubt whether he would die in this payment room. Every morning, the gamblers were ordered to kneel in a row, numbered off and slapped in the face accordingly. Once when it was Zhang Wan's turn, she was so stunned that she fainted on the spot. The older Lao Chen was already covered in bruises and was barely breathing, with blood leaking from his knees. Do you think the fearsome methods will end here? The fact goes far beyond this. People who could not pay, after spending 10 days in the forced payment room, will be transferred to death payment room. Compared with the life in the windowless and hopeless death payment room, the physical injuries in the forced payment room were nothing at all. more tortures await in the death payment room. For instance, gamblers were compelled to eat chili pepper, while drinking a whole bowl of boiling water, or tied up with ropes and hung upside down for a day and a night, and required to slap and kick each other heavily. Due to losing dignity and being brutally mistreated, each and every minute here is doubled suffering. The gamblers were filled with only helplessness and despair. So, could these gamblers who are deeply trapped in the payment room survive? Please stay tuned for the next issue, Detective of Qingqiao Safety.